ChargerLAB got a 10000mAh power bank from CUKTECH. It has a USB-A and a USB-C port that can support a charging power of 30 watts. It adopts two 21-7000 batteries and indicator lights, but it's small in size. Next, we are going to take it apart to see its internal components and structure. The box is in gray, and there are product name and appearance printed on it. The specs info are printed on the back, we'll talk about later. And there are three colors for you to choose. Open the box. In addition to the power bank, there is also a USB-A to USB-C cable. The cable adopts a flat design, and the length is about 32cm. Take out the power bank and remove the plastic film. It is small in size and has a unique design. The lower part has a matte design. And the CUKTECH and 10000mAh are printed on the front. The specs info are also printed on this side. Motor is PB100. The maximum charging power is 33 watts. The USB-C can support input and output of 30 watts. The total battery capacity is 10000mAh, and the energy is about 36.5 Wh. This side has a power button and two indicator lights that can show the remaining power. Here is the USB-C port. The other side has a USB-A port. Both sides of the ports adopt a concave design. The size of it is about 80x58x28mm, and the weight is about 194 grams. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows that the USB-C supports PD 3.0, PPS, and QC4 charging protocols. And it has three fixed PDOs of 5V, 9V, 3A, and 20V, 2.5A, and a set of PPS. The supported protocols of USB-A are UFCS, FCP, ICP, AFC, QC 3.0, DCP, and Apple 2.4A protocols. And it has a set of PPS. Now, let's start to take it apart. Use a spudger and a hammer to remove the cover along the gap. The cover is fixed with clips and glue. Remove the remaining case. Here is the inside of the indicator lights and the power button. The battery pack and PCB are fixed to the black frame, and they are connected by nickel strips. Disconnect the nickel strips. Here is the thermistor placed on the battery pack. Next, let's take out the PCB. The position of this gray thermal pad corresponds to the converter. The battery is glued inside the frame. These two 21-7000 batteries are from EVE and connect in series, 5mAh for each. There are sockets, alloy inductor, converter, and protocol chip on the front of the PCB. And there are VBUS MOSFET, indicator light, and battery protection chip on the back. The buck boost converter is from SouthChip. It integrates MOSFET and S2C port. The alloy inductor can reduce losses and improve conversion efficiency, 3.3 mAh. There are MLCC capacitors used for input and output. The protocol chip is from Chipsea. It integrates 8-bit RISC, 32K x16-bit flash, and 2K RAM. It supports multiple fast charging protocols. The protection chip is also from Chipsea. It supports CC1, CC2, SBU1, and SBU2 overvoltage protection. The VBUS MOSFET used for USB-C is from ChipSourceTek, 18V, 18mA. The VBUS MOSFET used for USB-A is the same as the previous one. There is an SMD button for power detection. There are 8 LED indicators with TVS for electrostatic protection. The battery protection chip is from MadeChip. It integrates voltage and current detection circuits. The MOSFET for battery protection is marked with 2002. The thermistor is used for temperature detection. Here is the black USB-C socket. USB-A socket is also black. Well, those are all components of this power bank. It is small in size and unique in design. The total capacity is 10000mAh. The indicator lights can show the remaining power, and USB-C can support PD and PPS protocols. After taking it apart, we found it adopts two 21,000 batteries to form the battery pack. The battery pack is fixed by a black frame. Its internal structure is simple and there is also punching compound for heat dissipation. Coupled with its unique appearance, it becomes a wise choice for small-sized power banks. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!